I try to use economic theory and data to better understand the US healthcare sector and the implications for healthcare policy. My name is Amy Finkelstein, and I'm an economist. At heart, I'm an empiricist. I love playing with data. I love analyzing it. I use a lot of different kinds of methods in my work. My goal is to bring rigorous evidence to bear on better understanding important questions in US healthcare, like what happens if we cover the uninsured with health insurance? How can we reduce healthcare spending without harming patients? And questions like that. The way I got started on randomized control trials, which was only about 10 years ago, was because the state of Oregon was trying to allocate a limited number of Medicaid slots, and they decided the fairest thing to do was to run a lottery. So they asked people to sign up and then literally randomized who was going to get access to Medicaid and who wasn't. One of the really amazing things about randomized control trials is they really have the power to surprise you or to surprise others in ways that when I do other types of work, if I get a surprising result, it's only natural to think, did I control for all confounding factors? What we saw was an amazing research opportunity to bring the gold standard of rigorous scientific and medical evidence, namely a randomized trial, to what was arguably one of the most important health policy questions of the day. If you think about the debates raging around the country about what happens when you expand Medicaid, there are all kinds of claims made by both proponents and people against expanding Medicaid. Our research from this randomized evaluation allowed us to cut through this rhetoric and see what was actually going on. Our results categorically refute the notion that Medicaid is worthless for uninsured people. We find that Medicaid improves financial security, it reduces out-of-pocket spending, it reduces medical debt. What Medicaid does is it makes healthcare free for people who were previously uninsured. So people are gonna use more care. We teach that in Economics 101, demand curves slope down. When you lower the price of something, people consume more of it. And what that means for the government is that they're hard choices or for society to make in terms of, you know, balancing the increased spending with the benefits. Another big issue that we've just started to dip our toe in is the opioid crisis. And we're trying to understand how much of the opioid epidemic is due to these person-specific factors like poor economic outcomes and substance abuse history, and how much is actually the result of doctor behavior and other supply-side policies. That seems a very important step in trying to understand the potential effectiveness of policies that could combat the opioid epidemic. The thing that excites me about economics in general and my work in health economics in particular is that economics and social policy are a science, and they can be examined with the kind of rigorous evidence and theory that is also applied to the natural world or the physical world. There are some basic facts about what the consequences of different types of policies would be that economics can answer.